Hello everybody. We are making a summary of what we have learned in this mathematics video. And the first I do is absolute 2x minus 1 equals to absolute 4x plus 3. Then minus 4x plus 3. The third is given as 2x here is 2x and 3 there equals minus 4. Then x is equal to minus 2 and here 4x there 6x minus 1 minus equals to minus 3 plus 1 minus 2. Then x is equal to minus 1 divided by 3. The other example is 2 minus 2x divided by 2 plus x less than or equals to 4. Then 3 minus 2x divided by 2 plus x is greater than or equal to minus 4 or less than or equal to 4. Then multiplied by 10 or this multiplied by 10. Minus 4 multiplied by 2 plus 6 less than or greater than 3 minus 2x or 4 or 3 minus 2x less than or equals to 4 multiplied by 2 plus 8. First then to then to that there and then less than or equal then multiplied by then. And this is us. Minus 4x there is 4x minus 2x is 2x greater than or equal minus 6. 3 comes here, minus 3, then 9, minus 9. Then x is minus 9 divided by 2. And here, minus 2x moves there, 4x is 6x. 6x greater than or equal to 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. Move here. 3 minus 8 is 5. Then x greater than or equal to 5 divided by 6. And here also x greater than or equal. Just a second, I must check again. Minus 4. Yes, it's 4 minus 2, 3. This is also, this is correct. Okay. It was therefore absolute velocity, absolute definition, absolute And you are going to work on another example. And if you really by x minus 3 equals to 7 equals to 2. Then you put 7 here, it is 8 divided by 4, it is 2, then it is correct, but we must approve that it is so. So we learn for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a beta greater than 0, so that, so as, so that. Or we should use so that absolute x minus 7 less than 0, then absolute x divided by x minus 3 minus 2 less than theta. We are going to continue with this. Absolute x minus 2 divided by L multiplied by x minus 3 divided by x minus 3 is less than beta, then 8 plus 3 is 14 minus 2 is divided by x by 3 less than beta. Then this one is 2 multiplied by 7 minus x divided by x minus 3. Because this is absolute, then we can change x minus 7 multiplied by 2 divided by x minus 3 less than beta. But this one is less than epsilon, then this one must be also then we can take a value 1, we can assume that this one is less than 1. Epsilon is very, very small bit, but when we take 1, then what is happening. X minus 7 greater than minus 1 less than 1. Then x minus 3. Then x minus 3. Is it minus 4? Comes here greater than 3 and less than 1. We add 4 in each place. 4 minus 1 is 3. X minus 7 plus 4 is minus 3. 1 plus 4 is 5. Then, absolute x minus 3 is greater than 3 and less than 5. Then, when we divide 1 divided by x minus 3, absolute is greater than 1, 5, less than 1, 3. Then 2 multiples. 2 multiples. So, then this one must be least, and the least value is 2, 5. Then absolute 7 is minus 7. X minus 7 multiplied by 2 divided by 5. Less than beta, then epsilon less than or equal to 5 beta divided by 2. Then we have 5, and epsilon, which in this condition gives us this condition. Then beta must be less than epsilon, must be less than or equal to 5 beta divided by 2. That is the limit exists. Okay. By x minus 2, then it goes to 2 plus. And this is equal to limit square x minus 2 multiplied by x plus 2 divided by x minus 2, x goes to 2 plus. If this one is positive and can go under, and it's going to be 9, absolute x plus 2 divided by x minus 2, x goes to 2 plus. Because we can use the square, this one of it by 2 comes under and it's going to simplify. And it is 4 divided by 0. Then this one is plus infinite. This one, then it goes to minus 2. Then if minus 2 is less than 0, it's negative. Then going to be 2 minus 8, which is minus infinite. Then x goes to my to 2 from left side, then this one is negative. And this one is negative, then this part which is positive is that part of the this one goes and the left, this one is left is minus this one on the square. And it is 2 minus 6. And it goes to 2 from left side. And it's going to be minus infinite. H of x equals to square root 4 minus x divided by 2. We will find the x that h become continuous, which means that limit of x goes to dot equals to in h of x equals to a minus equals to h of a. One solution is that use this one as zero. H of A equals to root 4 minus A 2 equals to 0. Then 4 minus A 2 equals to 0. Then A equals to plus minus 2. So 2 plus positive 2 plus from right side, then it is positive. From left side, is it positive? And both of them are the 10 plus is negative. Then negative is positive, and they are not the same. Let me check here and there. Is that this one becomes positive, then this one becomes positive, then A is greater than minus 2 and less than 2. Any value in this A belongs to minus 2 and 2. Any values in that interval make that function continuous. We are going to of A equals to f of A plus the delta x minus f of 2 divided by delta x, and it is linear. x goes to 0. Because then it is mean delta x to 0 a plus delta x on 2. Followed by 2 plus 12 minus 3, 2 followed by 2 minus 12 divided by delta x equals to this one is 3 or line delta x equals to 0. And it is 3, 4, plus 4 delta x plus delta x divided by 2 minus 12. That 12 and 12 is because 3 multiplied by 4 is 12 delta x. And this one is 12, this and this take each other. And what is left? Is left delta x goes to 0. And we have 4 delta x and delta x up to 2. Then it is delta x plus 4. Then delta x goes to 0. The limit is 4. And it is true. Extreme of x is 3 multiplied by 2x, it is 6x, and then x is 2. Extreme of 2 is 6 multiplied by 2, which is 3 multiplied by 4, this 12 then, and this 12. Thank you for courage. Now this is the card, and we want to show. Integral from A to B, x multiplied by 4 plus x, 1 plus x, dx. We use a variable, we use 1 plus x equals to u, then x equals to u 2 minus 1, dx is 2u du. Then we put it here, absolute or integral, u 2 minus 1 multiplied by u Москва, большую Илью, печи, интеграл, чую, 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 о, мене, чую, чую, печи, чу, Москва, бай. Two divided by five, U five minus two divided by three, U three, maybe use again the same. 2 minus 3 by 5, 1 plus x, up to 5, minus 2 divided by 3, squared 1 plus x, divided by 3, from to 3. Then is 2, 5 squared 1 plus 3 divided by 5 minus 2 divided by 3 squared 1 plus 3 divided by 3 minus divided by 5 plus 2 divided by 3. Then x is 0, this is 1. This is 1, this is 1. Then it is 2. It is 4. This is 4 divided by 5, which is 2 divided by 10. This is 4 power by 3, which is 2 power by 6. Then it is 2 divided by 5 multiplied by 2 power by 5 minus 2 divided by 3 multiplied by 2 divided by power by 3 minus, this one is minus 6, this is minus 6 plus 10 is plus 4 divided by 16. This one is 32, 64. Divided by 5 and it is minus 16 divided by 3 plus 4 divided by 16, which is 118 divided by 16. 118 divided by 16. We are going to questo. And y equals to x plus 3. And we call this for f of x and this for g of x. Then you draw the curve. It is slope and it is a line, and this one is g and this one is f, and the area, and then we rotate around the x-axis, and this point, minus 1 to 2, and we can have it by cross section of them, and x2 plus 1 minus x minus 3 equals 0. Then x minus 2 equals 0. Then x minus 2, x plus 1 is 0. Then x is 2 and x is minus 1. This is cross section. The cross between two curves. And we are going to use boolean v equals to p integral minus 1 to 2 f 2 x minus g 2 x dx. Integral minus 1 to 2 x to f of x is x2 plus 6 x plus 9 minus x4 plus 2 x2 plus 1 dx. V equals to p integral minus 1 to 2, and it is x4 x2 minus 2 x2 minus 6 2 9 minus 1 plus 8 dx, which is p x5 divided by 5 minus x3 divided by 3 plus 8x from minus 1 to 2, which is v equals to p 2 power by 5 is 32 divided by 5 minus 8 divided by 3 plus 16 minus 1 divided by 5 plus 1 divided by 3 minus 8, which is 33 divided by 5 minus 3, it is 9 divided by 3 is 3, 16 plus 24, which is 21. It is P and 33 plus 105 divided by 5, it is 138 P divided by 1. That calculation you can do it also very quick. But the most important is the method. F of x equals to 2x now plus 3 divided by x minus 1, and we need what is x inverse of x in the theorem function f. The solution is so simple. We use the 2x plus 3x minus 1 equals to y, and we solve x from this function. 2x plus 3 equals to xy minus y, and x there, it is xy minus 2x equals to 3 plus 1. Then x equals to 3 plus y divided by y minus 2. Then multiplied by then is xy minus y, and we move this here and this here. It is xy minus 2e, and it is 3 plus 1. And we factorize x, and we have this. Then x minus 1 x equals to 3 plus x minus 2. have another example. F of x is equal to 2 power by x, g of x is equal to 2 power by minus x. The area between between those two function and the line x equals to 2, and the function is like the that one or that one, and the line 2 is that one, then it is this area. Then we use those two functions, x0 is 1, and this one is 1, and from x from 0 to 2. Then the area is integral from 0 to 2 f of x minus g of x dx. By x divided by ln 2 minus or plus 2 power by minus x divided by ln 2 again between 0 to 2, which is 4 divided by ln 2 plus 1/4, which is 17 divided by 4 ln 2. Now, minus this one because of 2 and minus 1 plus 1 minus 2 divided by ln 2. This is the 9 divided by 4, 2 is 7. Divided by 4 ln 2. This is 16 plus 1 is 17 minus 8. This is 9. This is 17 divided by 4, and it is 8 divided by 4. 17 minus 8 is 9. y equals to x times y times by x. What is dy in x? That we use on the logarithm ln y equals to ln x squared by x. Then it is the dy divided by y equals to ln x plus x divided by x, which is 1 plus ln x. Then why is that? Then dy then dx dx then dy dx equals to y multiplied by d, and what is that? X covered by x multiplied by 1 plus ln x. Example is the trigonometric mean mean 3x divided by 3 5x equals to 0. This is 0 by 0. We can use Hopital or we can use another. We are going to use mean. Mean 3x divided by 3x multiplied by 3 x and minus 5x divided by 5x multiplied by 5x equals to 0, which is 3 half mean 3x divided by 3x mean 5x divided by 5x equals to 0. This is 1 and 1, and it is 3 divided by 5. F of x equals to mean x divided by 1 minus 2 plus x, and extreme of x equals to derivative of the numerator, which is cosinus x multiplied by denominator minus derivative of dominator, which is cosinus is minus sinus, multiplied by minus 2 is 2 sinus, but it is minus 2 sin x multiplied by sin x, divided by 1 minus 2 cosinus x divided by 2. Cosinus 2 sin x power by 2, which is cosinus x minus 2 cosinus 2 x minus 2 sin 2 x divided by 1 minus 2 cosinus x powered by 2. This is minus 2 multiplied by this, which this one is 1. Then it is equals to cosinus x minus 1 divided by 1 minus 2 cosinus x powered by 2. Another example is x cosinus y plus y cosinus x equals to 1. And it is within dy dx. What is dy dx? We take a derivative. The first is cosinus y plus x dy dx minus sinus 1. Plus dy dx cosinus x minus y sinus x equals to 0. Dy and the rest moves this. Then dy dx is cosinus x minus x sin y equals to y sin x minus cosinus y. Then dy dx equals to y sin x minus cos y divided by cos x minus x sin y. Integral 3x cosinus 2x dx. We know that sinus x plus b equals to sin a cos b plus cos b sin a. Cos a sin b. Plus minus. Then this one, then in A plus B equals to 1/2 in A plus B minus 1/2 in A minus B. So there, this is minus here and this is plus here. Then we use it here, this one, integral 1/2 minus 3x minus 2x is x minus 3x plus 2x in 5x, which is 1/2 minus cosinus x plus 5 divided by plus 1/5 cosinus 5x. Divided by the 4 minus 9x 2. Then we use 1/10 dx. of 3x divided by 4 minus 3x over by 2. Which is 1/3 mean inverse 3x plus 6. Okay, and another example is the integral dx divided by 3x2 minus 2x plus 5, which is plus the whole plus 1 line minus 1 line, then it is plus 1 third plus 5 minus 1 9. It is 45 minus 44 divided by 9. 44 divided by 9. And then this is 1 divided by square root of 2 times inverse of 3x minus 1 divided by square root of 2 plus 3. This is only to use this one as u. And solve this solution that it can be u2 plus 1 or plus something. And that's the part. And it is the answering that it is so. It's only a simple substitution we must make. example or another method. Divided by x minus 2 over by 3 is 3 divided by 8 minus 1 to 2, plus e divided by 8 minus 2. Which e? 8 multiplied by 3. 8 is 3. 4 is 2. 8 minus 8 plus 8. This one must divide by 8, and this one is 2. 8 4 minus 4 is 3 plus 8 is 2 minus 8 is 3. This is every angle. 3 is x2 plus 3. X2 plus 3. X2 multiplied by 3. So 3 is 3 minus 2x. Plus e multiplied by e x2. This is x2 minus 4 x plus 4 x2 divided by x2 multiplied by x minus 2 of power by 2. We have p plus e x4. P plus e x4 plus a minus 4b plus b minus 4e. So a minus 4b plus b minus 4e x3 plus minus 4a 8b minus 4a plus 8b plus 3 plus 4e x2 plus 8a 8a minus 8b minus 2b x plus minus 8a minus 8a only minus 8a equals to 4. This is x3 minus 1. This is equivalent to this one. See? And all of them on this. Then we have e plus e equals to, we have x4, no x4, then it is 0. And this one, a plus 4b plus b minus 4e equals to 1. This one is 0. Minus 4a plus 8b plus v plus 4e equals to 0. And here 8a minus 8b minus 2d equals to 0 because we have an x here. And minus 8a minus 8a equals to minus 1. Then a equals to 1 divided by 8. We put 1 divided by 8 here, here, here. A 1 minus 8, 7 divided by 8, minus 1, my coming here is going to be divided by 5. Equal 1, come here, it's going to be minus 1, and we put it there. Then, here. Make a matrix. And in first 1, 1, 0, 0. In that one it's 4, 0, 1, minus 4. In that one it's 8, 1, 0, 4, and minus 8, 0, minus 2, 0, multiplied by e, equals to 0, 7 divided by 8, 1 divided by 2, and minus 1. And when we solve the solution, get also 8 equals to 1 divided by 8, e equals to 3 divided by 16, e equals to 7 divided by 4, and then we put there, we put there. Then it is integral 7 divided by 4, E is 3 divided by 4, and E is minus 3 divided by 16. Thank you.